Our next Big Boss Lady is nobody else than Patrizia. Patrizia, she's an economist, she is an anchor woman, she is a journalist, and she dedicates her work to multiple projects, to focusing on technological progress, to business and finance, as well as on analyzing gender issues from an economical perspective and figuring out what the impact is of different incentives. She is very well known for breaking down complex topics to very simple, nicely understandable stories. And through this talent, she had all the big names in front of her camera, ranging from former Secretary of State John Kerry to New Zealand's Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern or the World Wide Web founder Sir Tim Berners-Lee. But that's not enough for Patrizia. She also writes op-ed columns at the Swiss newspaper Blick, where she recently also wrote, for instance, about Zalando or about the BBC challenge, about which we'll hear more later. And interestingly, Patrizia is LinkedIn Top Voice. For those of you who don't know what LinkedIn Top Voice is, it is very rare, highly recognized distinction. Because for the German-speaking area, there are just 25 most relevant authors that got this distinction. And globally, there are just around 320 of those. So Patrizia is one of those. Fantastic. And she uses her voice to stand up for topics that matter, for topics where she wishes to change the environment. She's also a frequent visitor at the World Economic Forum, and she started initiatives like, for instance, a Wikipedia edit-a-ton, because there are few female women that are on Wikipedia and we need more. So she initiated that. And she's up for the BBC challenge because she wants to have 50-50 female-male expert panels, and this is possible. So, dear Patrizia, welcome on stage.
Thank you so much, Petra, for inviting me here as well. I think it's kind of funny that, because I'm not a big boss, I'm just the pain in the ass of four big bosses, so it's quite cool that it took me on stage. Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome. We are super honored to having you here. And we also admire you a lot for standing up for the topic. You mentioned it's pain for some bosses, so it shows even more strength that you really stand there and don't give in. So let's start with a few.
It's harder with women, actually. I'm always nice to women. It's different behavior. Uh-huh. You feel that.
Okay, so it would be good for other women who have interviews with you.
Right now, yes. We don't have 50-50.
Good. So if an actress were to play you in a movie, which actress do you think would play you best?
Oh my gosh, okay. No, she should be like passionate, determined, a lot of determination. Mm-hmm. But it's really a hard question and shouldn't be too nice, I think. So, I think someone like really, I mean, Angelina Jolie, so I think she should play me, at least.
We take that. Who was your most impressive interview partner that you had?
You mentioned a few, but I think I would go definitely for Jacinda Ardern, so the New Zealand Prime Minister. And what she has launched, she really looked at the life of people and she defined a new policy, the well-being policy. She's not only orientating towards the GDP, because GDP there is not reflecting the real happiness of people, well-being of people, are they happy or not? And she really, she did a well-being budget, so very innovative. So I think one of the first states, head of states doing this and had the courage to change something. And she is really fighting against child poverty, because this is the future. Like, children are the future, especially in Switzerland. We don't have any resources, so it's really people, talent, and we should really start earlier to care about our future and our children.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you. So you're well known as an anchor woman in the Swiss TV. You have a voice out there. Tell us a little bit, how did you get there?
Yeah, actually, it's just a plan B. So maybe it shows as well that plan A, if you can't reach plan A, plan B works out somehow. So I wanted to become a strategy consultant, classic one. I really loved that, this McKinsey, BCG attitude, and it was so interesting. I thought I could really work there, and project-wise, I could have a look in different companies and compare it, and I found it really interesting. But unfortunately, when I graduated, the dot-com crisis came, the stock markets crashed, and they had hiring freeze all over. So I couldn't even introduce myself or get some interview because they just stopped everything. And but the media, they were really desperate for experts explaining all this irrational exuberance at the stock market. And so there it was. I had a lot of offers from the media, and I don't regret it that I took it.
we're happy that you took it. So when we met in a preparation, you were talking about your mother. Until she was 30 years old, there was no women voting right. To what degree would you say that your upbringing through your mother actually influenced you?
A lot. There is real energy and anger in me, and this fuels me, I have to admit, because my mother was brought up in a very poor region, mountain region. She was a daughter of a farmer, and she was born as a second-class human being. She had to wait 30 years to get the right to vote. I mean, Switzerland is one of the most conservative countries and really got the vote to right very, very late. She wasn't allowed to study or to even pick up a profession. When she was good at school, she got hit. And so, I mean, this was something like, and she dedicated all her life to subordinate or to serve the family and just serving also her husband. So it's kind of, I didn't have a role model, but what I experienced, this gave me a lot to fuel my motivation, because it's only one generation in between. It's really only one generation.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So some people, they say that they have a motto for life, something that drives them. You mentioned emotion and anger to a certain degree, that is something that fuels you. Do you have a slogan or something as a motto for life?
Yes, indeed, I have one, and it always changes a little bit every year or every other month. So, but this one, I really have, and also my favorite hashtags, of course, they always change. So I have Frauenstreik now, it's my favorite for this week. I hope to see you on Friday at Main Station at 5 o'clock. Just join and feel the forces. And this is actually not an event, this is a movement. I just wanted to say that. Now, would be really cool if you join us. But as you ask for the motto, for the slogan, I say, the world belongs to the courageous, or the courageous owe the world. Den Mutigen gehört die Welt. And I really think this is so, this really says a lot. So just disrupt yourself in a way and speak up, and dare speaking up and telling your opinion. Also spread it in social media, your content, your expert opinion, and I would love to meet you also on Twitter, because there are all the opinion leaders and there is all the media. And if you want to be discovered by journalists or the media, you should be there, even if it is like some kind of smart ass male dominated platform. But we really need support there. So come there.